Pan Methodist movement got its start in the bicentennial of the Methodist Church. It was a way of bringing the various fragments of Methodism together to celebrate our unity within our diversity. It was an effort of the bishops of the various churches, and it culminated for the bicentennial of Wesley's experience. And it grew as an opportunity for churches to work together, to evangelize, to work on educational opportunities, and primarily to use the methods of John Wesley, which was a society of faithful people making a difference in the neighborhoods and in the parish churches in which they live. I think what it can provide for our young people is an opportunity for education, an opportunity for mentoring, an opportunity for interpersonal growth, and primarily to have a full understanding of what it means to be a Christian, to live it, to share it, and to fully understand through their daily life that Christ is the center and the source of their lives, be it school, be it work, be it home, even during activities, that just normal things they do, Christ in the workplace. And I think the Penn Methodist Council has a very good opportunity and has helped to shape the lives of our youth. The Christian Church, I think, really has an opportunity first to debunk many of the false teachings of our age that too often we see with televangelism, the prosperity gospel, the name it, claim it. Nowhere in Scripture, and particularly in the parables of Christ, do we see a pie in the sky by and by doctrine, but primarily work ethic. Throughout the parables, we hear Jesus talking solely about work, about planting, sowing, saving. And I think that the church today can offer the world the opportunity of what the church has done for 2,000 years, is making the most with the less, and making less grow. And I think that the Christian lifestyle, the Christian doctrine, the direct teachings of Christ, help us to see how to store our treasures, and not just temporal things, but those things that build and make communities last.